I've been trying to experiment with different ways to create color with the latex printers. And you have certain workflows that I've talked about in other videos. You know, you have using generic presets. Generic preset for most people is perfect. You have an adhesive vinyl, you choose generic front-lit adhesive vinyl and you print with it, you get excellent results. And then there's media-specific downloads that you can get from the media locator and right on the printer panel. These are specifically built for a specific media. And then you also have the ability on the 360 and 370 to do end-to-end color profiling right on the printer. You do the first chart, the second, and the third, and you've built your own presets. What I want to show you is another little wrinkle I've been playing around with, which was specifically helpful for the 310 and for the 330. What I'm going to do is I'm going to build generic profiles plus, or sometimes I call it profiling light. The core important thing of building a preset is speed, temperature, ink load. And if you're given an unknown media, something you've never seen before, and you're going to print it on the latex printer, let's say you have a 310, and you have to 54 inch of some kind of adhesive vinyl. Well, the first thing I would recommend is try to get some baseline settings. What we're going to do is we're going to create a new media. We're going to build a media specific for this new vinyl you have. And we're going to do it in a two-step process instead of a three-step process. But first, you have to have some kind of starting points. Now, on the printer, when you go to the panel to create a new media, it's going to ask you what type of media it is. And you would say adhesive vinyl. And then it's going to ask you, is it a front-lit or is it a back-lit adhesive vinyl? And you're going to say it's a front-lit. And then you're going to run this chart. We're going to show this chart quite a bit. It's a very important chart. So I've printed this chart at 10 pass. I can tell it's 10 pass because it includes 110 and 120% ink. If I did it at 8 pass or less, it would only go up to 100% ink. These are the densities available at 10 pass on this calendared adhesive vinyl. When you print the chart, as we've discussed in other videos, you're looking for, is it dry? Is it coalescing? In other words, is it a nice solid color or does it have kind of that fish-eyed look? And is it bleeding? If it is dry, it is not coalescing, and it is not bleeding, you can choose that number. So we loaded this up and then chose 10 pass at 230 degrees and ran this chart. And this is what we have. So we're going to pick a number. So it appears that 110 is perfectly fine. We're going to choose 110, and then we're going to go to the next step. Now, in a sense, what you've done right there is the most important cornerstone of like building a house. You made your foundation. This is the foundation of all printing. The next step we're going to do is we're going to print out a chart, which is the color calibration. Now, all of the latex printers have the ability to print a color calibration. This is a color calibration chart from the 360. That's what I have here. But we also have color calibration charts for the 310 and the 330. Those will also print a chart. It looks a little different. It's a little smaller and it's kind of over towards one end of the printer. But it's still a color calibration chart. It's going to establish how much ink per channel and then it's going to build a linearization. And we always recommend running that chart when you download new medias into the printer. In this case, you're building a new media, so you're going to run that chart. And then when you're done running this chart, it won't look quite like this, but it's the same color arrangement. It's ink restrictions and a linearization. You're going to finish by hitting done. Once you hit done on, say, a 330, you now have your cornerstone, which is your ink densities and your global ink limits, as well as your ink restriction and your linearization. All of your core color calibration is completed. Now, all printers are smart. What they're going to do is they're going to associate an ICC profile with the color calibration you've already built. And they're going to base it on the category you chose earlier. So when you choose SAV front lit, inside the printer, there are different profiles built for different densities. Now, it may not have been made on your exact adhesive vinyl, probably wasn't. But it's going to be very close because calendared adhesive vinyl is pretty similar to other calendared adhesive vinyl. What's different is if you felt that your adhesive vinyl was a little temperature sensitive or you had a little bubbling or rippling, you want to bring the heat down, well, you would reduce the heat, let's say from 230 to 225. Run it at 10 pass, run this chart, pick an ideal density, do your color calibration, and then the printer is smart enough to associate that density automatically with an ICC profile. In other words, it's completely sort of a closed loop system. You're not building the ICC, which this is an ICC chart, like you can on the 360 and 370, because the 310 and 330 do not have a spectrophotometer. They don't build the ICC profile. However, they have ICC profiles for every category already built into the printer, and the printer will automatically associate the correct ICC based on the category you chose with the two first sets you did, which is this print and the color calibration. So in a way, it's doing roughly two-thirds, and probably the most important two-thirds, of a complete preset. And those are the mechanical settings combined with your density settings, and then associating them with your color calibration. That works very effectively. In a lot of cases with a 310 and 330, I do the first two steps. Those are the only two you can do. I hit finish. The printer automatically links to an ICC internally. The rip is connected bidirectionally, so it reaches out and gets that information, and you're good to go. I think you'll find that the results you get from following that workflow are highly customizable, and they're easy to use, and it takes advantage of the full reach that both the 330 and the 360 are capable of. Now, a 310 and 330 are capable of. Now, a 360 and a 370, they can build their own ICC as the last step. But most of the hard lifting is really done right there. And that's the most important. So if you want to build your own sort of profile light or generic plus, that's another way you can use the 330 and 310 specifically to get the best results for custom media that might not be on the locator or you're not really sure what it is.